Hey gang, and welcome to your very first Material UI tutorial. Now, just really quickly before we start the tutorial, for those of you who want to support the channel and join the gang officially, you can do by clicking that join button right here. It's just 99 cents or pence per month, and you get these cool little ninja loyalty badges next to your name in the comments down below when you leave a comment. You can also join by clicking the button right beneath the video if you're watching one now, which I'm guessing you are. It does exactly the same thing. All right, so now that's out of the way, let's get on with the tutorial. So then, first things first, what is Material UI? Well, Material UI is just a UI component library for React that comes fully baked with loads of easy to use components for things like buttons, navbars, form elements, a grid system, etc. And you can see all of these different components right here. Now, they're all styled following the material design specification. And material design is just a design philosophy by Google, which bunches together a load of design best practices and principles for websites and apps, so that website or app users have a solid, consistent, and generally nice experience when they're on them. And it includes specification for things like buttons or navbars, banners, chips, checkboxes, different form elements, all that kind of stuff. So it's a bit like Bootstrap, but by Google instead. So when you use Material UI for your React applications, your website components are going to look the same as the components that we see right here. So just so you can have a quick peek at what a React application looks like using Material UI, I've prepped this project right here. And this is the mini project we're going to be building as we learn more about it. And along the way, I'm going to show you how to implement a bunch of Material UI components like cards, this app bar at the top, avatars, icons, the side drawer, the grid system, and also a bit about web forms as well. And on top of all of that, I'm going to show you how to use another package called React Masonry CSS to give us this Masonry grid system right here. And we'll do that at the end of the series. So if we take a quick look at the code that makes up one of the pages I just showed you, you can see that using Material UI basically just means using a bunch of pre-made components like container or typography for text or a text field for a form input. So this is basically 90% of what Material UI is, and we can customize how these different components look using props. And the good thing about using Material UI is that it is very customizable. We can create custom themes to personalize how our site looks, and we can also override these default styles of components using our own CSS and a styles hook that Material UI gives us. So we're going to learn how to do all of this and more over the next 18 lessons or so. So instead of creating a new React app from absolute scratch to start this project, I've already prepped a bare bones starter project with just a couple of blank pages and the React router setup as well. And I've uploaded this to GitHub at this repo right here, Material UI Tut. So the link to this is going to be down below. And to get this starter project, just make sure you have the lesson one branch selected right here, and then you can download a zip folder of the project. Now, I've already done that, and it's right here on my desktop. So I'm just going to extract this right here. So extract. And then when it's done that, I'm going to open up this window, and you'll see this folder, Material UI Tut Lesson 1. Now, I'm just going to rename this. So Material Tut, just so it's shorter, and then I'm going to right click this and I'm going to open it up with code to open it in VS Code. And this here, my friends, is the starter project. Now, like I said, this is a very bare bones setup. It's not got much boilerplate in it at all. If we open up source, we can see the root component app.js, and inside here, I've already set up the React router. We import all the things we need for that to work right here from React router DOM. And by the way, that is in package.json as a dependency right here. So this router tag surrounds the switch tag, which means that only one route will show at a time. And this route right here is to the exact path forward slash. Then we show the notes component. This one right here to forward slash create. And in that case, we showed the create component. Both of those components are being imported from the pages folder, which is where our page components are going to go. The notes one, dead simple, just some text that says notes page. And the create one, the same. This time it says create page. So that is pretty much it. We also have this index.css file with some very basic styles to begin with. And inside the index.js file, which kickstarts the app, we're importing those styles right here and the root component so we can set it up. So that is basically it for the startup project. Now, the first thing we really need to do is open up a terminal, and then we need to install all of the dependencies, because when you download this code from GitHub, the dependencies are not present. We don't see a node modules folder anywhere. So if we run npm install in the root of our project, it's going to look inside this package.json file at all of the dependencies, and it's going to install all of those. If you don't do this step, nothing is going to work. Cool, so now that's done, we can run this project in a browser by typing npm start and hitting enter. That's going to spin up a local development server for us so we can preview this. And it's opened up in a browser on my other screen, so let me just scoot that across over here. And we can see just this notes page text right here. This is the notes component for the root path. And if we go to /create, then we should get the create component. Okay, so next up, we need to install Material UI into our project as well. So go to the Material website, and the link to that is going to be down below, and click on Get Started. And if we scroll down, you see we can install it by saying npm install at material-ui/core. And this is the core part of the Material UI library. Now, it includes most of the components, but not the icon ones. But don't worry, we'll come to the icon ones later in the course. So I'm going to copy this, and back in my project, I'm going to open up a new terminal and then paste it in and press enter. So that's going to install Material UI for us. Now, there's one more thing to do. Material UI under the hood uses the Roboto fonts, and it doesn't include this in the core library. We have to install it ourselves. So all you need to do is grab this link right here, or go to the Google Fonts website and grab it. But you can just grab this and paste it inside your index.html file right here. Now, if you got the starter files, I've already done it for you and it's right here, so you don't need to paste it in twice. But anyway, now that is Material UI installed, in the next video, we'll take a look at our first component, and that is going to be the typography component.